Hey everyone, in this video, we're going to look at JavaScript for the Flipper Zero. This is just a demo script to try out some JavaScript code. We'll look at the code later. Here we have a demo where it counts starting at the number you specify. Mass storage is an example of exposing a USB drive to the host computer. You could save your BadUSB payload results on this drive. And I also wrote a demo where we map the Flipboard buttons to do different things. So if we press the second button, it uses BadUSB to pull up a picture of our Flipper. The third button, and we can even do subghz. Let's get started. The good news is we have JavaScript for the Flipper and it continues to evolve. But the bad news is JavaScript has different module support depending on the firmware you're running. I'll try to keep my wiki up to date with the latest changes. Currently, official seems to have the least amount of support, but hopefully that will change in the future. I'm in Visual Studio Code running Momentum firmware under Applications, System, JS App. Under Modules, you'll see all the different modules that are supported in the firmware. And then under Examples, there's apps, scripts, and then the various JS files. I wrote the intro JS file that we're looking at today. I'll put a link to the file in the comments. I'll go ahead and right-click on the file and choose Reveal in File Explorer. And then in QFlipper, you can find those on Files, SD Card, Apps, Scripts. At the top of our file, we have let variable name equals require, and then in quotes, the name of the module. Do this for all the modules you want in your script. We'll jump to the bottom of the file and we'll change this to awesome demo. We'll hit save. We'll drag our JS file over to scripts, and then we'll go into apps, scripts, intro. And there's our change. So we have to use the let keyword. If you use var instead, it won't work. So let's go ahead and save that. Copy our file over and we'll run that. And you can see var is not implemented. So you have to use the let keyword. You also have to use the equal, 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 or exclamation mark, equal, equal. If you say equal, equal instead, the file loads without an error. However, when it runs, you'll get the use equal, 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 not equal, equal on line 135. So we'll switch that back to equal, equal, equal. I jump back to the top of the file and I'm going to go ahead and add a let test equals require of test. And there is no module name test, so we'll see what kind of error we get when we have a module that doesn't exist. You'll get a test module load failed, and it tells us that the error is on line 10. So we'll go ahead and delete that. And now let's go ahead and take a look at that count. So when we did the counting demo, our value was a zero. And when it was a zero, it called our demo count function. Our demo count function is right here. Let's go ahead and run this. And you can see that it set the header saying starting count. And that's that. This is how many characters we're allowed to type. So if we look, we can just keep typing in characters. And then the 1337 is the text that's the default text. And false means whether or not to highlight it. If the person presses the back button, then the text will equal undefined. Let's modify this code to allocate 4 bytes instead of 100. We're only seeing 3 characters. And if I back this out and type in digits, it's still only 3 characters. This is because it reserves a byte for the null terminator. So let's go ahead and add a byte for that null terminator. And then we'll go ahead and copy our updated script back on the Flipper. And now we can see that it allows four characters. And if we backspace that out and type, we get four characters. So always add one for the null terminator. So we'll go ahead and run the script from 1344. I'll freeze the flipper output so we can look at the code. We do print text in the text string, and then we use the built-in parseInt function to convert the text into a number and assign that to the variable count. And then we have a for loop that initializes I to 0. And then while I is less than 4, it prints the count plus I. And then I++ increments the count by 1, and it checks I again. Once I is 4, the loop exits, and then it prints counting done. Next, let's take a look at mass storage. So when we choose mass storage, it's option 2, which calls demo mass storage. And then demo mass storage, the underscore underscore dir path is the path where our script is located. We add 4mb.img as our file name to that path. If storage exists is false, then we call usb create image to create that file. And then we call usb disk start to attach the drive. And then while the USB disk is not ejected, we delay 1 second each time. And then once it is ejected, we stop the disk. You can see that 4mbimg file exists, so let me go ahead and delete it. And then we'll go ahead and run the script. So it says creating image because the file didn't exist. It then attached our drive, so there's our D drive. And now it's waiting for us to eject the drive. I'll go ahead and bring up PowerShell, and we'll do a get disk. And you can see that friendly name is flipper mass storage. So if we run get disk friendly name and partition and volume, we're able to find the drive letter that was attached. So we can use this if our bad USB scripts want to copy their results back onto the attached storage. In a future video, we can look at how to change that friendly name to hopefully avoid AV in the future. So we'll go ahead and right click and eject that drive. And so now that while loop exits and we do USB stop, and you can see the flipper again. And then next we wanted to look at that Flipboard GPIO demo, which was option 1, which is demo Flipboard. And demo Flipboard uses the text box to show a non-blocking message on the screen. And then while that text box is open, so it goes away when we click the back button, we're looking using GPIO to see if the button is pressed. Depending on the button pressed, we'll type different text, or we'll use subghz module and do a transmit file. The nice thing about this is it's very easy to update your scripts to do whatever text you want to type or whatever payloads you want to transmit. If we look at that is pressed, you'll see that we're using GPIO read. Since the GPIO buttons are initialized with pull up, they give a low value, a false value when the button is pressed. So we use not to switch to be true for false and false for true. That type text is using BadUSB. I'm setting it up using the vendor and PID of Apple keyboard. We try 10 seconds to keep checking to see if the keyboard's connected yet. And then once it's connected, we do the Windows R, and then we type in that text and press enter with the println. And then finally we do quit, which returns back to the normal USB connection. Thanks for watching the video. Now you know how to edit and run scripts. You know about the let and require keywords. You know about the different module support. And we looked at some modules such as BadUSB, submenu, textbox, storage, keyboard, etc. Please like and subscribe and leave a comment below letting me know what you'd like to see in JavaScript.